Hello everyone, this is Sam from DATEC Studios. In this series of videos, I want to explain FFD modifier in 3D Studio Max. FFD stands for Freeform Deformation, which I explain what does it mean in practical way. I create a plane here and convert it to editable poly. Pressing Ctrl M for a couple of times to increase subdivision. If I want to bend this plane, easily I could apply bend modifier to that. Also, this is one of the usage of FFD. So I remove this modifier. And while this plane is selected, applying FFD. There are a couple of FFD modifiers here, which I will explain in this series of videos. FFD 2x2x2, 3, 4, box and cylinder. I start with FFD 3x3x3, which these numbers explain how many nodes we have in freeform deformation modifier. So I select FFD 3x3x3. If I open this modifier, you see we have three items here: control point, lattice, and set volume. I select control points, or while your modifier is not expanded, simply click on that. You could select control points. And now, for example, if I move these points up, like bend modifier, your object bended. However, you could still use other transformations too. I move to other side, enable scale transform, and start scaling. As you see, this modifier gives you power to modify your subdivided geometry easily. I remove this modifier and apply FFD again. So if you press number 1 or click once more on FFD or open and select control point, you could select these control points of freeform deformation. I press W to select move transform and start moving up. Basically, this modifier works something like Bezier's with handle. Imagine you have these control vertices and generating a curve between these points. If I select only parts of this geometry, for example, I grow this, and while your geometry partially selected, any selection type like vertex, edge, border, polygon, and even element. And again, if I apply FFD modifiers, I could work only on selected geometry surface area. If you need a smoother result, I could go to editable poly again. From the soft selection, enable use soft selection and set your desired values. Again, go to FFD and start transforming. Also, this modifier works with couple of separated geometry. Instead of having one single object, I create a box and clone it, and few more. If I select all these geometries and go to modify panel and select FFD, still you could apply freeform deformation to whole selected geometries. Select once, select any control points and start deforming. even I could start rotating and achieve my desirable result. I think now you have general perspective of how FFD modifier works. So I delete all these geometries, creating a cube and increasing segments. Now from modifier list, if I select FFD, for example, this time 2x2x2, in each axis we have only 2 points. 2 for X, 2 for Y, and 2 for Z. So I could select any of those and start transforming. As you see, if you carefully analyze this modifier, you could do many jobs of similar other modifiers. For example, if I apply taper modifier and set taper amount positively or negative and curve, we have this result. I clone this geometry, remove taper, also FFD 2x2, I think we need FFD 3, so I select FFD 3x3, and here I'm trying to reach something like left geometry. So select to activate your control points. I select all top control points. Going to scale transform and start scaling down. Also, I could increase the scale in the middle to achieve more similar results. If I apply twist modifier and start twisting based on your desired angle, I could do same again with this FFD modifier. So select FFD again, select all top control points and start rotating. I could do something more accurate. So I enable angle snap or press A from your keyboard and start rotating. I think 70 degree or 80 degrees enough. Now select top part and again any angle amount you want. So until now, we simulated bend modifier, taper modifier, and twist modifier simply with FFD modifier. I remove all geometries and create another cube and increasing segments. Go to modify tab and here we have FFD 2x2, 0x2, 3, 4. Also, we have two different types, FFD box and FFD CYL, which short enough cylinder. If I select FFD box, in FFD parameters, dimensions part, there is a button named set number of points. You could simply do previous FFD modifiers here, which there was 2x2x2. It is exactly similar to FFD2. I could increase 3 or 4 also. So I set 3x3x3 and OK. As you see, we achieved exact same modifier. But FFD box modifier gives you much more control. You could set any number you want. Also decrease. Maybe in this box I need only control points for height, so I decrease the length and width and increase height something like 6. Now we have 6 points for height and only 2 points for length and width. I'm going to front view by pressing F from your keyboard, enable scale transform, also enable your control points. I could deform this geometry any shape I want. I select these control points, start scaling down, and middle points, scaling up. If your geometry is cylindrical shape, FFD 2, 3, 4 or box usually is not suitable for this transforming. Because your geometry is cylindrical, but your FFD modifier is box. So I could select FFD cylinder, set the value I want for any dimension, side, radial and height, and start deforming. Something like that, very easily achievable. Sometimes you have complicated geometry shape. For example, imagine I have something like this shape. And if I apply FFD box modifier, it is not so suitable. So what can I do here in this situation? If I open modifier, there is an item named set volume. If you enable set volume, now without affecting your geometry shape, you could simply move and set your control points position. So I start to work manually. Actually, I think we need more control points here. So click on set number of points and add point for length, I guess. Now start reposition your points. I'm going to top view to control better. Alright, something like my geometry silhouette. Now, if my geometry subdivision is more than previous, allow me to increase subdivisions by connect. Alright, now I could select control points from FFD and start deforming in any direction or any transform I need. Also, you could do stack of modifier. So while I applied first FFD modifier, I apply second one, something like FFD3. Now you have based on your geometry. Again, if you need control your points or set your volume, you could do it easily and start transforming. Also, another interesting thing, FFD works for 2D shapes too. If I create something like circle or rectangle or any line or shape types, I can apply FFD to this 2D shape too. So I select, going to top, and start deforming. I think that's enough for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos. See you in next video. Goodbye.